guys. Hope everyone's great. We're going to do a quick reading and see what's coming in for you guys this time. Let's get started. At the bottom, we have the Four of Cups. Waiting, patiency, contemplating something, could be. And the Six of Swords, swimming away from the situation towards calmer waters. Seems things maybe were a little murky and for your taste. Yep, we got the Sun and the Emperor. Happiness. This is what you long for. This is what you seek. This is what energy you can be in and are in. Dominant masculine energy here. You do feel somewhat stuck in your head, though, over about something. We have the Ace of Cups, Queen of Wands, the Empress, so Emperor and Empress, okay, we have a match, and the Six of Swords. Let's find out why that's here. Why is the Six of Swords here? There could be another woman involved, or someone is keeping you around right now, because they don't have anybody else, or they want you. They want a victory with you. Six of Wands here. Let's get your person's energy, the Two of Wands. The Knight of Wands could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This person looks a little devious. Maybe they're not. Maybe there's something that they're up to. What's this? Queen of Pentacles. Okay. Five of Pentacles, feeling left out in the cold. I'm hearing money for merit. So someone could be stressing about a money situation right now. Something about, like, could be a burden or feel like a burden to you or them. What else? One more card, please. It's coming in. Judgment. Scorpio energy. Alright, let's get the out. Death card, more Scorpio energy. And Three of Wands, looking in a direction. What is ultimately going to be best route for me, best suitor for me? We have the Strength and the Seven of Wands. Yeah, you're going to defend something to the very end. You're standing in your power now. Okay, so why is this Eight of Swords here? We have the Star in reversed. Somebody feels like they're not good enough. Or adequate. Who's giving this Ace of Cups to my collective? Six of Pentacles in reverse. Someone who's not fair, who doesn't play by the rules, by the book. We have the Magician representing the Queen of Wands. Could be someone who's doing, who has ill intent or dark magic, spell work. Binding spells, yeah, because they didn't want you to walk away from them. This is just turn. This is a plot twist. Four of Cups representing the Empress, but you already released whoever this toxic karmic is. You've already released this person. Show me the six. No, show me the Two of Wands here. Nine of Pentacles. Together, you guys could have wonderful things, blessings, if you both are going to put in the effort and give equally to this partnership and turn that Six of Pentacles upright. We have the King of Swords representing the Knight of Wands. Show me this Queen of Pentacles. Why is it here? Sign, water sign, fire signs, all here, and a little bit of air. Why is this Queen of Pentacles here? Who Who's this Queen of Pentacles? Why is it here? All right, we got the Nine of Cups. Someone who's very abundant. Could be a baby mom. Why is this Five of Pentacles here? The Wheel of Fortune. Closing one cycle. It's no longer feeling the need to be left out in the cold. At the bottom of the deck. What's this Judgment card? The Two of Cups. They want to make sure everything is perfect. The right person. You could already be married to this person. Aries energy at the bottom. An exciting adventure. Leaving the past behind. Not taking it with you. Ten of Swords. Let's get the best advice. Ten of Pentacles. Focus on work, money, how to better yourself at this time. That's all I got for you guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Subscribe if you're new and stay tuned for more videos. Take care now. Bye.